President, welcome to the White House. Welcome to the Oval Office.
Thank you very much. It's really an honor for me and for Chile to be here.
Well, I tell you, it's an honor. Look, you know, the only problem I have with you is you're too young.
That's not a problem.
I got elected when I was 29. I think 30 years old to be a senator. I had to wait. President, that's pretty good.
Well,
that's what I called you.
I was elected when I was 35 and 27 for Congress. You were elected at 29,
sir? 29.
Yeah.
29. You have to be 30. I had to wait 17 years.
Well, we are sharing the same path. Yeah. Hope to get as far as you did.
Well, it's great to have you here and happy to see you again. You know, this year, Chile and the United States celebrate 200 years. 200 years of bilateral relations. They are. I think our partnership is stronger than it's ever been.
Yeah.
And one of the things that together, through our America's Partnership for Economic Prosperity, we're going to grow the economies of the hemisphere from the bottom up and the middle out. You know, I've said many times that there's no reason why this hemisphere shouldn't be the most prosperous, most democratic hemisphere in the world. We have all the makings of that, and we're standing up for democracy and freedom, human rights, the rights of workers. And I know we share those. Together, we're working to address historic levels of migration in the hemisphere. A lot of people moving around, and I admire the way you handle it, particularly the Venezuelan refugees, which you set an example for the region. And so, as we embark on this next century partnership, let's make it even stronger.
Well, that's why I'm here for. Thank you for receiving me and my delegation. We are celebrating 200 years of diplomatic relationships, but also 20 years since our free trade agreement, which has bring a lot of benefits for both of us. I'm looking forward to strengthen our relationships, and I'm glad to be here also to the American partnership, the APEP meeting. Hope we can talk on that. We have a lot of values that we share. Of course, the preoccupation for human rights, democracy, and also the rights of the workers in the world. I saw you supporting workers here in the States a couple of weeks ago, and I think that's very valuable from a president. And we have a lot of topic to discuss: the green transition, of course. Migration, the economic development, and of course some issues that are going on in this world that it's really hard nowadays, but I know with the respecting human rights and fighting for democracy, we can reach some of the goals we share.
Well, you know, there comes a time, maybe every 6 to 8 generations, where the world changes in a very short time.
And we are at that time now.
We are. And I think what happens in the next 2-3 years is going to determine what the world looks like in the next 5 or 6 decades. And so together, maybe we can make it better.
Let's work for it.
All right. Let's do it. Thank you all.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Mr. President, has Israel agreed to a pause?